Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. I am Preeti. In this video, we will see what is Dataverse in Power BI and how to create report using Dataverse connector. So let's get started with this. So our main agenda are: what is Dataverse in Power BI, prerequisites for Dataverse Power BI, how we can connect Dataverse connector in Power BI, and finally we will see how to create a Power BI report using data from Dataverse. So first of all, what is Dataverse in Power BI? With Power BI Desktop and Microsoft Dataverse, you may generate reports and publish them to Power BI by connecting directly to your data. You can create reports and publish them to Power BI using Microsoft Dataverse and Power BI Desktop by connecting directly to your data. So with the help of the Dataverse connector, it is simple to use Power BI to visualize and analyze data from the Microsoft Dataverse. Power BI reports can be used in dashboards, shared with other users, and accessed across platform via Power BI mobile apps. Using Power BI, which offers a variety of services and features, you may view your company's data. Data from the Dynamic 365 Sales and Customer Services apps, as well as from the Microsoft Dataverse, may be easily visualized and analyzed by using Power BI with the use of the Dataverse connectors. Next, what are the prerequisites for Dataverse Power BI? So the first point is download and install Power BI Desktop. First of all, you need to download and install Power BI Desktop, a free tool that runs locally on your computer. You can download Power BI Desktop online. So directly you can click Power BI Desktop and you can get the link and you can over there. The second one is you must have read access to a table in order to access its data. So a Power Platform environment has some following rights, like as I said, you must have read access to a table in order to access list data. And the second one is you must have a security role with maker privileges such as system customizer or environment in order to alter a table in make.powerapps.com. So fourth one is need necessary Power BI licenses. To create and share Power BI reports, you need the necessary Power BI licenses. And the fifth one is must have the enable TDS endpoint setting enabled. So before using Dataverse connector in Power BI, you must enable one feature that is present inside the Power Platform Admin Center, that is called as TDS endpoint. So your environment must have the enabled the TDS endpoint settings in order to use the Dataverse connector. So finally, we will see how we can create a Power BI report using data from the Dataverse table. So let's get started with this. So this is the Dataverse table called Job Seekers Registration List that I am going to create a Power BI report by using this Dataverse table. To create a Power BI report, first of all, you need to open the Power BI Desktop, and after that you need to sign in with your Microsoft 365 credential. So once you will sign in Power BI Desktop, you will see this type of screen, home screen. This is called Power BI Desktop home screen. So before creating a Power BI report using Dataverse connector, first of all you need to connect the Dataverse to Power BI. So how we can connect that? You can see here the get data option. Just click on it. Here you can see Dataverse. So here you can directly connect to the Dataverse table or Dataverse connector to Power BI. As well as the another approach is there. Go to the file tab. Here just click on the get data, and after that click on the get data to get started. Once you will click on it, you can see here the get data window will appear. Here click on the Power Platform and then you can see the Dataverse over here. Just click on it, and once you will click on it, just click on the connect button. When we will click on the connect button, it will redirect to this navigator page where it displays all the environment that you have in Power BI. So here my environment name is TSInfo Technologies Default. Just expand that this environment. Once you'll expand it, just select your Dataverse table name, that is Also, you can search over here, job seekers. So once you will click on the navigator button, you will navigate to this page where you can see your specific environment, that is TSInfo Technologies default. Here you just select your Dataverse table name. My Dataverse table name is job seeker registration list. So here I'm selecting this one. So as it is a Dataverse table, so it is the table name, Dataverse table name is appearing with the prefix, that is CRF9A_job_seekers_registration_list. Just select it. Here in this screen you can see the preview, means what are the columns, what are the data is available in that table, in the Dataverse table, it will appear here. Now all the data and all the columns you can see over here. Once it is loaded, just click on the load button. You can see in the below, load. When you will click on load, this connection settings window will appear, where there are two options, that is import, one is import and one is direct query. So choose one of the following data connection models. So what is import? So whenever possible, we recommend that you import data into Power BI. Data is cached in the Power BI service and imported on a regular basis in this manner. And what is the direct query? So direct query, it connects to Dataverse data directly. So you can utilize this mode to retrieve the data in real time. This mode can also enforce the Dataverse security model more strongly. By default, the connection setting will be import only. So as I want to do import connection settings, so just click on OK button. Once you will click on the OK button, the Dataverse table will load like this, and it will take some time, just some seconds to load this table. So now you can see our Dataverse table job seeker registration list is already loaded, and in the right side, the data, under the data section, you can see all the columns over here that you have created in your Dataverse table. So now the Dataverse connection is ready to make or to build a Power BI report in Power BI desktop. First of all, you need to choose one visualization. So here I am choosing one donut chart visualization. So click on it, just dragging it center, and here you can see legend values details. So I will put two things, one is name and one is graduation percent. I want to view the graduation marks of each individual person. So what I will do, so the name you can see over here, just drag and drop the name on the legend section, and the graduation percent you can see over here. The graduation percent here you can see, just drag and drop in the values field. So here you can see the donut chart is ready for each individuals. So here what we'll do, here the 9.04% is the graduation mark, and the right side you can see all the names. So once I will click on a specific name, it will display the graduation mark of a specific person. So in the bracket you can see the 13.99, that is for percentage. So if you want to remove this percentage things, so what you will do, just click on this format your visual and go to the expand the details level. So here you can see the level contents, so click, just expand it and just choose on the data value. So now you can see the donut chart has only one value, that is graduation percentage. So if I will click one more like person, so it will display the graduation mark only. So in this way we can build our Power BI report by using Dataverse connector and or Dataverse table. If you want to know more details about this thing, then you can visit our site spguides.com. We have this article on our spguides.com site. You can visit over there. Also, you can get this article link in our description box below. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you really like this video, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit this bell icon button for more videos like this. Thank you so much and have a nice day.